solves that problem. And also poses a new one.
Just when I think this land holds
still, at least. What this does. If a device breaks in a cave and nobody is around to complain, did I really break it?
Thank you.
Careful. I've spotted a trap.
Smells worse over here than a dozen Romneys.
Well, let's track down my old pal. Can't hurt to know who wants us dead.
If Anne smiles and... As you suck the smoke deep into your lungs, your vision starts to swim and cloud. There is an intense pounding in your head, and you can feel the world fading. As the world fades away, you lose all sense of being grounded. You reach out, but you could feel yourself falling slowly, sinking into the depths of your own soul. Thank you. As you approach, Ralik greets you with a salute, though his face is marred by a pained grimace.
My, my. How you positively brim with sauce. No wonder, after all the adventures you have had, all the things you've had to do. Oh, it's naught but a chill. Bit drafty in your soul, that's all. You should...
A sudden shudder jolts through his body so violently that he drops to his knees, stunned into silence. He whispers that there's really no need for your assistance, but the weight of his arms around you tells a different tale. An ancient curse escapes from his lips, spoken so forcefully that for a brief moment, all light recedes into the webs of darkness.
I have told you before, the void is stronger than ever, but so are you. I can sense the expanse of source inside you. You are ready to learn the spell I've yearned to teach you, the spell you will need when we reach the Well of Ascension. I have given you eyes that see the source. Now I will give you the teeth to take it.
Ralik smiles, and you notice for the first time two vampire-like fangs glistening beneath his upper lip. A gulf of magic envelops you, and you feel a sudden, insatiable hunger for source.
Go on. I'm here for you. Give in to your hunger. Do not heed me or any other. Only your own lust for power, just like a god should. Go on. Devour me.
Though your spell tore through him like a spear through flesh, Ralik looks grimly happy, if haggard.
You speak the spell with brash ferocity, like I knew you would, my champion. Of course. Do you still not see? Do you still not realize there will never be satiety? Let me tell you the one truth about what it means to be a god. It is to be the lion in a world of lambs. It is about power. And power is not given, it is taken. With your all-seeing eyes and your all-consuming teeth. You can see the souls of the dead. And now you can feed from them to your hungry heart's content. So feed, for you will starve until you finally feast upon the Well of Ascension. So you are. Your soul has become a vast enough expanse to house divinity. You are ready. We must hurry now. We must race toward the Well of Ascension with all the determination of the eagle diving for its prey. Your prey lies on a far-off shore, at the heart of the Nameless Isle. It is a place no one can reach unless their soul becomes their compass.
He places a hand over your heart, and you suddenly feel it, an unmistakable pull in a new and distant direction.
I'm sorry to tell you, but there is no such way. The battle for divinity is about to begin in earnest. The other gods and their chosen will try to outflank us, just like we must outflank them.
But I will be with you. I will guide you, stand by you. I will watch as you drink from the wellspring, and as its source surges into you.
The void will be overcome, and you will be the god of gods. The end is nigh. Don't fail us now. The nameless isle awaits you.
You jolt back to the world, stumbling forward. Dark smoke surrounds you, hanging in the air like black fog. This feels wrong. The Meister's cry cuts through the haze. You look up just in time to see what steps out of the shadows.
Seems to be the code to a safe. Better hang on to this.
As you suck the smoke deep into your lungs, your vision starts to swim and you feel your body trying to pull itself forward, trying to drag you away, but you're being held back. You feel weak, feeble, and aching for source. You return to the world, coughing violently. You feel drained, but thankfully, the Meister has a source fountain in her basement. As you suck the smoke deep into your lungs, your vision... The man brandishes a sword, ready to fight. A curious weapon, simple but weighty. It seems out of place in the hands of a simple worker, if that's what he is. You have your doubts, for the sword exudes an evil power.
Back, Magister, or I'll cut your guts for ribbons like I did the last fella. The Magisters are dead? What? All of them? And you did that. I don't know whether to thank you or fear you. You have them. And with that, I shall leave.
He gives you a stiff salute, then climbs the ladder to face his destiny. The thought occurs. The Magisters have strayed from the path of Lucien.
Their dedication to their cause is almost admirable. If one could admire a pack of red-cloaked baboons.
Were they ever on it?
The louder people shout in a god's name, the duller becomes their understanding of its message. Lucian would be appalled.
This was my dead father's house. Sorry, Dad.
You can nosy around camp, but watch it. The docks are restricted. Even I'm not allowed down there. If you come back bleeding, don't say I didn't warn you.
Looks like trouble. The divine order kind of trouble.
Hurts, doesn't it? I'm ready.
Greet the Reaper for me.
Thank you. Those whites are hypocrites. Every last one of them.
Two white magisters are discussing the fate of three magically bound captives. Captives clad in the dark shroud of the Black Ring. Noticing your arrival, the magisters step back and take hold of their weapons.
You? Ah, yes. I remember your face from Driftwood. Shouldn't have come here, you silly little sod.
Indeed. And your presence is most unwelcome.
Ah, of course. But I'm afraid that doesn't matter anymore.
We have to get moving, Raymond. Let's end this.
The two magisters whistle up their source hounds and advance upon you, deadly intent darkening their expressions.
Hounds, take them down!
The fact of the matter is, you lot have outlived your usefulness. Out. You lot have outlived your usefulness.
You're not trying to escape, are you?
Thank you.
ready.
Doesn't it?
Doesn't it?
Worms take you.